Welcome back, beautiful people, to another Rebirth World project. We have here center number one. As you can see, I have a check there. I've just tested something. Let me show you. If I say here move and put, and I run this. Oh, of course, I had to place one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, let me rerun it. Bam, boof. I'm done, right? It looks like this level is done, but it's not. What we have to do is, check this out, is from 1 to 11, but if I reset it, actually reset it to 11 is again. Come on, man. See, now it's 9. So we have to finish this project with random widths. Okay, let's check the world info and keyboard. Help Reborg to find the center of the world. The height of the world will always be equal to 1, but the width is an odd number which will vary between 3 and 11. What you need to know is turn left, move, turn left, and put. The conditions front is clear or wall in front and object here. How to use while loops and if statements. Suggested strategy. Rebirth carries many tokens. A possible strategy is to only use 2 tokens to put one at each end of the world. Then by moving them one step at a time, Rebirth could find the center of the world. Okay, we have a lot of clues in here to solve this thing. Let's start from the beginning. The height of the world will be always equal to 1. Why? But the width is an odd number which will vary between 3 to 11. So, we have clues there, in terms of we can use numbers. We can use positions to finish this, and we can use while if statements without numbers. I will try with while if statements. Okay, let's just go. I will say comment. I'll say while if. Place tokens at the end of the world. For that, I just have to say wall in front, turn left, turn left again, put, and then move. Okay, this will be, let's make a function. I will say I'll say just place okay, so this will place our token to the end of the world and move one location. Let's say if not if front is clear, I will say, let me think. Object here, take, otherwise move. Wait a second. True. So place will go to the end of the world, turn around, put the token and move one. Okay. Move. After that, I will say if object underscore here. Take. Wait, no. If object here turn. Wait a second. So it will go again there. It will find me an object. Turn two times to the left. And I'll say move and put. Okay, so this one will place me there. It will move from here. Here we'll place the token. After that, the front is clear, move. It will move up the way to the object. Here will turn left. It will move once. It will place the token here. After that, wait a second. I have to check it. Yeah. We don't have a wall. This will look. Okay. Wait. Why it's I don't get it. We don't have a wall in front. We don't have a wall in front. I don't understand why. Actually, let's not. I'll copy that. Right. If we have a wall in front, turn 2 times left, poof, and move. After that, it will be if front is clear, object here, turn left. All right, let's see. If wall in front, semicolon, classic. One, not at the correct location. Okay, let me see. So, wall in front. Turn left 2 times. Actually, we have to say here. Take, move, and put. What a cute fast level. Let me see. Yeah, we did it. That's it. It's not complete. Oh, wait. It's not complete because the while loop is always true. We have to say when to end. Okay. We have to say when to end. Turn left. Ooh, let me think. Here is done. No, it's not. No, it's not done. Okay, so this will do what I want, but is definitely not done. Okay, let me think. What happens if I say here break? I never use break. I never use break, to be honest. Look at that. Okay, and right over here. Me see. All right over here. I think it's a indentation thing. I also have to work with return. I have to read about that and practice that. This is an interesting challenge. Let me sink. The front. If it's definitely an indentation thing and a work of break. It's an indentation thing. This is used only the first time. To place at each end of the world a token. After that, it will just loop between these two. So at one point, right here. Actually, not there. Wait. Here. If this is basically the same thing. It doesn't work. So the front. Stuck here. I bring everything to the center of the world, but I'm stuck at closing the loop. I have some ideas in my head, but how can I resolve this? But it seems that I can't connect what I'm thinking with the code. All right. Now all I have to do is just to break the code when everything is in the center of the world. I was thinking of writing a code that will always display me the center based on the range from 1 to 11, but we cannot connect it to the actual randomness in our table. If I make a range from 1 to 12, it will just loop for every number. Also, another thing that I've done here with the if statement, if the object here, like the token, is wait a second. Wait a second. I have to check another thing. If can I use object here is greater than or equal with 2? No, because it's like he has object here. Then the project, it's done. Let me see. List with an integer. So this is a list. We did it. I don't get it why it gives me an error, like one object is not in the correct position. Because I've did it. Look at that. I placed one happy face, one token at each end of the world. No, I mean, yeah, we can call it that. Let's. Okay, after that, I'll take it and I move one position closer to the center of the world. Each one. Take again, move one forward, take again, one forward. Take again, center of the world, done. One or more objects are not at the correct location. Are you kidding me? The challenge is complete. Okay, this is the closest. Here is done. Okay, let me see. Just Okay. Bomb bomb. All right, now. No. Wait, I've okay. Oh, baby Jesus. Oh, baby Jesus. Oh, baby Jesus. It works. It works. It works at random stuff. Yes! Yes, it works! Let's try this one. Oh, yes, it works. I just want to see the check. That's it. At this point, I just want to see the green thing. I'm done. Okay. Now, I am sure that are a lot of ways to resolve this thing. At my level, I just wanted to use if, while, if, elifs. I don't want to use numbers and for loops and stuff like that. I just want to use while, if, elifs. Also, I've tried in the beginning with two tokens. Even in this mode, I place two tokens at each end of the world and I bring them closer and closer. But in the center of the world, there needs to be only one token. The mistake that I've done in the beginning is that I placed both tokens in the center. And that is why the program was not complete. It only needs to be one. It displayed by that blue one, right? Okay, this is done. Let's see one more random one. 342 steps. Okay, let's see a three again. 7, 184 steps. Perfect. In the next one, guys, we'll try center number two, which will be. Okay. We increased the challenge also by 1 point. See you in the next one, guys.